dribble, and down the middle he goes up. High power, and he gets spun around as he slams it. Oh, you talk about excitement here in the stadium. Elevation on his shot.
Now the Bulls beat the pressure. Jordan from Mitchell.
Was that pretty?
Here's a pass stolen by Jordan. It's a 3-on-2 for the Bulls. Michael on the drive, in for the left, for the jam, and a foul!
Oh man, Kelly Chipuka couldn't run out of the play quick enough. Jordan was bearing down on him from the sky.
He came around Chapman and he went up, and Kelly was going to stop him. Woo!
Michael in for the left side, jammed it right over Rowland.
Michael Jordan just went by everything. Livingston went down on the fake and up over three.
Oh, what a move by Jordan! It counts.
First of all, Jordan on the beautiful dismissal of the defense. Case Starks and then Oakley, and then the deception. No, I'm not going away from the hoop. And who's at the end waiting but Patrick Ewing? And still, he is not denied in a most dramatic slam dunk finish. Making a shot like this.
Nice cross court feed. Jordan going and throws it up. And Jimmy puts it in on an amazing move.
Oh, they had the trap on. Here's a pass by Orlando Woolridge out of the corner. Lifted to Michael too far. He has to catch it, comes in, goes around. Ron Nixon flips it up off the glass and hits educatedly.
Under 4.5 minutes to go. Here's Jordan.
Oh, yeah! There's the mustard shot by Michael.
Jordan on the penetration, jumps off his right foot, turns his back, looks for John Paxson and says, John, you're out of the action. I'm shooting this ball here.
There, Mike, look at this.
Michael Jordan. Here's Jordan in deep on Elo.
Oh, yeah! Oh! We've seen them all, Jimmy. We've seen them all. And it always happens to Craig Elo.
Jordan!
Oh! Oh!
Jordan past Petrovic.
Wow! Oh, yes, yes, yes!
There were about three or four New Jersey Nets in his path.
A matter of elevating before Divac can make the rotation over.
Michael. The winner.
He does! Ring it up! Michael Jordan has beaten the Hawks again! He went deep into the ball. Knocked the jumper down when he came out. What shot, what can win?
Jordan against Wilkins, lost the ball, picks it up, moves to the circle, 2 second fadeaway shot, good! Game's over, and the Bulls win, he did it again.
Michael right over Wilkins and in his face, and the Bulls have swept the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Michael Jordan, incredible shot for the left side at the buzzer.
Here comes Michael Jordan on the drive, 5 seconds. Jordan on the drive, right of the lane, 18 footer.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Bounds the card right to Jordan. Time winding down. Michael for three. Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yes! 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 A winner! Unbelievable! Oh, yeah! Michael has saved his best for last.
They're going to double off the ball. Pippen and Hodges will cross along the baseline. The inbound pass comes into Jordan. Here's Michael at the foul line. A shot on Elo. Good!
The Bulls win it! They win it!
That's a Cleveland Cavaliers! Michael Jordan hits it at the foul line. The game's over, and the Bulls have won. Jordan beat him at the buzzer with a jump shot in the circle. And Chicago has knocked off the Cavs 101 to 100.
Basketball, the chance to win it right here.
Kukoc has got the ball inbound for Pippen, and here is Michael. Four on the shot clock now. Keeps it on the dribble. Russell's there.
MJ, top of the circle against Russell. Michael hangs, fires, scores!
And it goes well! He knocked it in at the buzzer, Bulls winner! How many times has he done that? It's all over! The Chicago Bulls have won at the buzzer!
They swat at him and steal him. Here comes Chicago. 17 seconds. 17 seconds from game 7 or from championship number 6. Jordan. Open. Chicago with the lead.
Watch Jordan's left hand here as he gives Russell the push. Referee can't see that. Jordan frees himself up.
for a clean look. The greatest thing about Jordan is he has all the tricks. That's why it's so difficult to guard him.
That may have been the last shot Michael Jordan will ever take in the NBA.
The 1-2 punch of Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen.
Michael in transition.
Yes, sir. Michael down the lane, a blind pass, and his teammate hammers it down.
Jordan, a little insurance. How did he find Longley in the lane? What a wonderful pass in deep by Michael Jordan to Luke Longley.
Oh, what a play to Pippen.
Woo, my, what a pass by Jordan. A wraparound pass as he was facing the other way. Hit Pippen almost perfectly in stride, and Pippen took it in and threw it down.
Cloud on their feet here at the United Center.
It'd be a scoop if anybody but Michael Jordan takes a shot.
It is Michael Jordan time. Scottie Pippen looking for Michael Jordan.
Michael, 6 seconds, five. Michael in traffic to Curl, 15 footers. Curl, carrying the jumper.
5 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter.
Michael with a dribble against Rivers. Michael down the lane, a fake, hangs, fires, score!
Well, I have too many memorable moments by Michael Jordan. None of them are good for me.
Stockton, inside of Carl Malone, they double it. Jordan knocks it away from him. Jordan's got it.
Favorite, I don't remember seeing many favorite things in person.
I don't have a favorite Jordan moment, but I have a Jordan moment that I'm like very, very tired of people coming up to me and giving me a hard time about.
There's Jordan for three, yes! Did you see that?
There's nothing else he can say other than the man steals it and lets us know.
Everybody asks me all the time, why'd you let Jordan bust you like that? What was I supposed to do? I had a hand in the man's face.
Guarding this guy, I think, made me a better defensive player.
every guy out there think they know how to play defense, but when you go against a guy like that, who can chew you up at any time of the game, you don't know how to play defense. His offensive skills were just unbelievable. You find yourself watching him instead of guarding him a lot of times.
Oh, yeah! Showtime for the Bullies!
My first year joining the team, we played him down in Chicago. That's when the first year he came back. He stole the ball and got on a fast break. And I forgot, you know, I was on the sideline, so I jumped up off the bench. You know, all of a sudden I'm like, yeah! And I'm like, oh, no, I'm on the bench of Magic. I hope they don't see this.
And the ball deflected by Jordan. Gets it ahead. Watch out.
With the steal and the jam.
One bounce dribble now to Jordan. Michael in from the left side. Jammed it right over Rollins. What a power dunk right through the seven-footer, Tree Rollins.
And I remember being right there in the small living room, sitting on the floor with my socks off, watching him play. And the guy was on him, and he fakes over his head like he was going to pass it. The guy slips and falls, and Mike goes to the lane and dunks it. And one of his teammates is behind him pointing at the other guy. And I just remember that. That's just one of my favorite moments of Michael.
He's playing against the New York Knicks in the playoffs, and I think he must have drove baseline. He faked one way against Charles Oakley, and he spun back the other way, and he drove to the lane and went up for a dunk, and he dunked right over Patrick Ewing, and he stared at him. I think that was one of my most memorable Michael Jordan moments.
Jordan trying to shake off Starks. Oh, what a move by Jordan! It counts, and the foul! That is one of the moves of the season.
First time he entered the league, that was my favorite moment. Just the impact that he had on the league, just coming into the league.
The Chicago Bulls pick Michael Jordan of the University of North Carolina.
Perhaps you can turn that Bulls thing around. What do you think?
Hopefully I can go in and contribute and maybe turn it around. You know, I'm looking forward to that.
The emotional part is when he won the title and he was holding the trophy and all the emotions came out.
The Chicago Bulls have won their first ever NBA championship.
And just to see that. Yeah, it's okay. Men can cry when they've done something that they've put their heart into and not worry about how people are going to perceive them.
Well, the last shot of his career, you know, when the little crossover, little pat on the butt and the jump shot.
Stockton against Kerr, into Malone, low left. Malone had it chopped away by Jordan, stolen by Jordan. 19 seconds, no timeouts for the Bulls as they work into the front court. All right, it's win or lose, game six for the Bulls.
The last shot he shot ever, you know, didn't hit no rim, and it won the game for him.
Big shot, the guy falling down, not being able to get to him.
17 seconds from game seven, or from championship number six. Jordan, open, Chicago with the lead!
The Chicago Bulls have won their sixth NBA championship in the last 8 years.
Oh my God, that was beautiful. What a feeling.
Leaving the game on top, I think that's a nice way to be remembered.
Not too many guys can end their career making a shot and end their career winning a championship. So if you had to end it anyway, that was the perfect way to end it.
They say I'm crazy, the way you got me open, baby. Ooh. They say I'm bugging, the way I'm time sweating your loving. Ooh. They all sit and wonder why this feeling I cannot hide. It ain't a question of pride. Ooh. It's love, it's love, it's love. Ooh. It's love, it's love, it's love, it's love.
Is it the shoes? Money's gotta be the shoes.
Shoes, shoes,
shoes.
Look, Pop, I can fly.
With these thumping sneakers.
I overcome the acceleration of gravity by the application of my muscle power in the vertical plane, thus producing low altitude Earth orbit.
I got it. What about the shoes?
Up north, Carolina, Edgar, 6'6", Michael Jordan.
What'd you expect? You're my friend?
Yo, this is Mars Black. This is my main man, Michael Jordan. And this is a pair of hype Air Jordans from Nike.
Look down at the camera just a little hardy.
Turn my engines on so you can't look.
These niggas be housing across the country. Let me repeat myself. These niggas be housing across the country. Capiche?
Mars Blackman here again. You know, nobody in the world can cover my main man, Michael Jordan. Nobody.
Let's keep on. So, back to one. Sorry about that.
Shut up! I'm doing a Nike commercial here! Shut up!
Amazon, man.
Yo, Mars Blackman here, my cut.
That's good. All of us, anytime we jump in an incomplete orbit. Well, Michael happens to jump in a more complete orbit than the rest of us.
You know?
Let me pull upon you. You can look in the camera. He stays lying.
Play like Jason, you know?
I think Bugs is more of a point guard than Spike. Spike is more of a coach.
A what?
He doesn't like to play much, but he loves to talk basketball. That would be the prime position for Spike as a coach, but Bugs would be a point guard.
Bugs really, when he heard about the campaign, he wanted it to be called the Hair Jordan as opposed to the Air Jordan.
Bugs, I watched Bugs a long time when I was a kid, and it didn't seem he lost too many battles, so I knew him would win.
Not only Michael and Bugs, but we have a relationship with Nike that will hopefully join other Looney Tunes characters.
And we both wear Nikes, so that makes a difference. He's a little bit light on the feet than I am.
Somehow my mind presented a challenge that I just couldn't refuse.
All my dreams when I was a kid to play Major League Baseball, and I think this renews that a little bit.
48 minutes, I get to do whatever I want and how I want to do it.
He's back! He's back!
That comes in playing and challenging the best competition. And seeing your game evolve as you meet each and every challenge day in and day out. And when you need that remembrance of dominance, you go back in a past situation and bring it into your mind to get you in the right mood or right mode to deal with the challenge that you're faced with at this particular time.
Everybody knows that at some point in time I'll have to stop playing basketball, and I've been given an opportunity to direct the company.
Make the logo bigger.
I had to approve the storyboards. I gave them certain concepts to think about, where my life, where my career is at this time. We are running this company that we feel can mold and build upon the concept that was originated by Nike. We've kind of taken the baton from them and expanded and taken a whole nother step. Placing this maybe right up above the score.
Is it the black?
Oh, yeah. My man, he brought a smile to my face. He's to be worn tomorrow. I am here to announce my retirement from the game of basketball. There won't be another announcement to baseball or anything of that nature. I'm not the type of guy that just put my name on a product and let it go out and sell, you know, especially with something that's been with me ever since I stepped foot in the game of basketball in the pros. So I got to have input. I got to put my little touch on it. I like that. I love that one.
You never showed me this one now. Because you knew I picked this one first, didn't you? Because I like the ribbon. I like the ribbon with the suede and the white bottle. Connect these two. I love it.
Blue. No.
Represent. This training shoe is about lost words. I just enjoy the game.
I didn't play a harsh style. I didn't play a physical style. I played a graceful style of game. When you look at events, there's an enjoyment there, certainly a creativity there. I think the Jumpman symbolizes creativity, but yet still a joy and love for the game. The tongue, the long pants. You know, it was a difference there that made the Jumpman, it was my own.
You guys gonna make me blush.
Chicago Bulls pick Michael Jordan, University of North Carolina. The Bucks 9-0 here. Down and oh! Holy Toledo! Here comes Mr. Jordan, is right.
And here's a steal. Jordan, the link of the floor. That's why it's
Jordan. Oh, give him a 10.
Back to Jordan.
Oh,
no.
This guy is your rookie of the year.
Jordan trying to fake Bird, can't do it. Hits the jumper. 10 points in this period for Ames. What a great shot.
Michael in the drive across the lane. Turnaround shot. Got it. 63 for Jordan. A new NBA record.
They gave him a 50. They gave Jordan a 50. He defends his championship. Against Lever. Wow.
In a league of stars, in a game of stars, you were the star of stars. Congratulations on being the 1988 All-Star MVP.
The inbounds pass comes into Jordan. Here's Michael at the foul line. A shot on Elo. Good! The Bulls win it! They win it!
Six straight scoring titles. You are simply the standard by which basketball excellence is measured. Congratulations.
He feels it. There's nothing.
to go on the shot clock. 15 in the ballgame. Michael will take it. He's fouled. He scores. He threw it up. Off balance and went in.
The Chicago Bulls have three straight NBA championships.
I've always stressed to people that have known me and the media that has followed me that when I lose the sense of motivation and the sense of to prove something as a basketball player, it's time for me to move away from the game of basketball. I just feel that at this particular time in my career, I've reached the pinnacle of my career. I've achieved a lot in that short amount of time, if you want to call it short. But I just feel that I don't have anything else for myself to prove.
For the NBA this season, 55 points by Michael Jordan.
The inbound to Michael, racing the clock. Jordan for the win.
Yes! I did it again! He is now back!
MJ between them all! He got every one of them!
You still set the standard for greatness, determination, and leadership. Congratulations, 1995-96 NBA Most Valuable Player.
Michael Jordan on the breakaway.
Basketball and a chance to win it right here.
Kukoc has got the ball inbounds for Pippen, and here is Michael. Four on the shot clock now. Keeps it on the dribble. Russell's there.
MJ, top of the circle against Russell. Michael hangs. Michael against Russell, 12 seconds, 11, 10, Jordan to drive, hangs, fires, yes! Scores! He scores! The Bulls lead 87-86 with 5 and 2 tenths left.
The Chicago Bulls have won their 6th NBA championship in the last 8 years.
I am here to announce my retirement from the game of basketball. I've accomplished everything I could as an individual. And right now I don't have the mental challenges that I've had in the past to proceed as a basketball player. I chose to walk away knowing that I can still play the game. And that's what I've always wished, you know, for my career to end. You know, that's exactly the way I wanted to end it. My efforts to try to make this team a successful one, it's quite naturally it's going to take some time, but I look forward to the challenge. I know it's a lot of people probably saying that, you know, just by Michael Jordan being in charge and making decisions, he's never had an opportunity to do that, and you know, maybe that's not, you know, the ingredient that may turn this team around. But then again, it may be. I will be here as much time as it takes to turn this team around, and that's my definition for how much time I'm going to spend here.
When it came to the slam dunk, nothing was better than Air Jordan taking to the sky.
It just makes you wish that for one day and for 1/8-10 seconds that you could fly in the air.
He's such a trendsetter. I mean, everything he's done, everyone's trying to do that.
You better not close your eyes, because I may not never see that again.
His slam dunk legacy started during his rookie year at the 1985 slam dunk contest.
Fans came. All-Star Weekend, he'll tell them what you would see.
And Michael would give the fans something they would never forget.
He wants to indicate where he's going to take off on this dunk.
Fly! Woo! Slam it! They love it. So does Michael Jordan.
And his foot was honest to that tape.
The contest would feature another slam dunk specialist, the man simply known as the Human Highlight Film. Dominique Wilkins. These two supreme high flyers would take to the air in the slam dunk final.
Michael Jordan is now in a little bit of trouble.
This is the last one for Michael Jordan. He feels the pressure.
But Michael would rise to the occasion.
Oh, spectacular.
Dominique would answer in spectacular fashion.
Here he goes. Oh, that'll do it.
Creative, what an athlete, and a plenty of style for Dominique Wilkins.
Dominique Wilkins of the Atlanta Hawks, the new 1985 slam dunk champion.
Michael would return to the slam dunk contest in 1987 in Seattle, prepared for victory.
Hey, Jim, I really want you trying to conservative what? We don't know if you want this or I'm
going to go. You just want to stay mellow.
This time, though, Dominique Wilkins was injured and not participating. But that didn't hold Michael back from putting on a show.
Oh, that was great. I wish I had the hands to do that.
Michael Jordan, I'm telling you now, he says, I've named them. Every one of them is the $12,500 dunk.
Michael would find his main competitor in the unknown Skywalker, Jerome Kersey.
Jerome Kersey looks strong. Your dark horse pick, Rick Barry.
Give me some home dunk. Keep it in North Carolina. Yeah, keep it in North Carolina. Give me some.
Leave it to Air Jordan to give the people what they wanted.
There he goes. He goes in straight, goes up in the air. Now he's sideways. Look at the air. Look at the hang time. Look at the flying motion.
Look at his head above the rim.
That is Air Jordan at his best.
Looked like he was in an F-16 that time.
Kersey would answer every time.
And Kersey comes in. It comes off the glass. The big catch and reaches through with authority from behind. A 50 for Kersey.
Now it was Michael's turn.
Now, Michael Jordan told me he had something special. He may be trying to take off from the free throw line, a la Julius Erving. Let's see what happens.
I can hear his engines revving now.
Air Jordan ready to take off.
Chicago.
Michael would show everyone why he is called Air with a spectacular dunk from the foul line, awarding him his first slam dunk championship.
I'm thinking it's going to be one of the better slam dunk competitions that they ever seen, and I think it's going to be on. Watch out.
We're going to make it look exciting.
Well, they're on their feet in Chicago for this man, their man, the defending champion, Michael Jordan.
The next year in Chicago, Jordan would start right where he left off the year before, above the rim.
Jordan wants to put some pressure on everybody by trying to do something special right out of the gate.
That's the one he calls the kiss the rim because he takes his face right up to the rim, ducks it under, and then windmills.
The long-awaited rematch with Dominique Wilkins was on, and Neat would answer the call.
And a 49 for Dominique Wilkins to put him in first place.
It was becoming a heavyweight battle of epic proportions.
Much like a heavyweight championship crowd, you know, and they are trading big, heavy right punches.
Neek needed a perfect score.
From high above the rim.
Well, the heat is on.
And the pressure was back on Michael.
Well, now Jordan does have his first taste of pressure in the slam dunk competition.
And Michael is backing all the way to the middle of the backcourt.
Mission control ready for launch.
Play, baby.
It was Michael's stage, and he wasn't going to let the hometown crowd down.
Well, the crowd lets you know what they think of it. They gave him a 50. They gave Jordan a 50. He defends his championship.
In one of the greatest slam dunk contests ever, Michael would defend his title and solidify his trademark of Air Jordan.